Welcome to this presentation for the ICT4S 2020. My name is Andreas Fritsch. I'm a PhD student at KIT in Germany. And the topic of the paper that I present here is Integration of Sustainability into Day-to-Day Business, a Tactical Management Dashboard for Organizational Lifecycle Assessment, O-LCA. The paper was written by Vera Büdel, the main author, by me and by Andreas Oberweis. And as you can guess from the title, we have designed a concept for a management dashboard that is meant to communicate sustainability information. We focus on organizational sustainability, so the question, how sustainable is my organization from a holistic perspective? And the main problem that we address is that the results of such a sustainability analysis tend to get, quite complex really quick. And so there are ways needed for effectively presenting them, since what is not understood is not addressed. So what do we mean with a holistic perspective? By this, we mean that we focus on or that we orient our approach on organizational lifecycle assessment. Organizational lifecycle assessment is based on product lifecycle assessment, but extends the scope to cover the full lifecycle of all the inputs and outputs of an organization. And what distinguishes organizational lifecycle assessment from conventional sustainability analysis is this life cycle perspective, so from raw materials to end of life for all of the inputs and outputs of the organization, and also covering multiple impacts and not only one impact for the analysis. So here you can see several impacts as example, environmental impact categories like water use, land use, global warming potential, etc. So this is what we mean with holistic approach. The second building block for the sustainability dashboard is, dashboard design. And by dashboard, we mean a performance management tool that summarizes and visualizes data and presents the most important information on a single screen. One can distinguish several types of dashboard designs. You could also see this as a spectrum from high-level information displayed in a strategic dashboard to operational dashboards that are used to monitor singular critical processes. And we have focused on a tactical design, meaning the use that we have in mind is that of causal analysis and exploration of the lifecycle information for managers or analysts. It should provide summarized but also detailed information, updates not on an hourly or daily scale, so longer terms, validity of the information, and it should provide several interactive design elements to qualify as a tactical management dashboard. These are the requirements that we implemented in our design. Those denoted with O are the ones that are derived from organizational lifecycle assessment. Those that are denoted with D are the ones that are derived from dashboard design elements. I will present all of them now one after the other in the following slides. So O1 is the display of the organization's current sustainability indicators as well as its objectives. Setting a clear goal for individual sustainability indicators should help managers to translate lofty sustainability visions into concrete practice. And we figured that the goal or the target value should be displayed together with the current value on the same scale for a better overview and interpretation. And an appropriate solution for this would be to display it in a so-called bullet graph, where the actual value is displayed as the length of this thick bar, and the target value is displayed as a crossing line. The advantage of this visualization is that you can already pre-attentively perceive whether the target value is exceeded through this cross shape. And in addition, a color coding serves to divide the scale qualitatively into bad, medium, and good values. O2 was the aggregation and display of the sustainability indicator hierarchy. So aggregation of sustainability indicators is controversial in literature. The issue is that it hides information. We still propose an aggregation scheme for the indicators for the dashboard in order to reduce the complexity of the display and to reduce the amount of information to a cognitively processable quantity. And this is the proposed concept for the aggregation. I will briefly walk you through it. It allows some freedoms in the concrete implementation. For example, we don't prescribe a fixed list of impact categories, and also the weighting may be implemented differently. For more information, I would point you towards the paper, or even more detail you can find here in a document that we published in this Git repository. So for now, just a brief overview of the different steps of the aggregation scheme. The first step is common in LCA in that the inventory data is characterized and allocated to different impact categories. And then in this proposed scheme, these impact categories or these impact indicators are normalized, weighted, and aggregated. By normalization, we mean that the displayed value are finally on a scale from 0 to 100. And a weighting that is proposed here would be distance to target weighting. This means that the actual value of an impact category is related to the target value of the organization. And the more the target value is exceeded, the greater is its weighting. And once the impact categories have been normalized and weighted, they can be summarized in a composite indicator for environmental, economic, and sustainability dimension. The aggregation formula is used, which would allow an individual definition of the assumed degree of weak and strong sustainability. So finally, the calculated composite indicators of three sustainability dimensions are combined into one sustainability indicator. By default, we propose here an equal weighting. We talked about the disadvantages and advantages of an aggregation of indicators. It hides information, and that would be the disadvantage. And to somewhat mitigate this, we propose to display the hierarchy of the indicators, or to make the hierarchy available for the user of the dashboard. Like you can see here, the different bullet graphs, so the indicators and target values displayed for the individual indicators, and here for the different sustainability dimension, and here the composite indicator for sustainability altogether. You can explore in the dashboard the interdependencies and see how the individual indicators are combined, and also the weightings are displayed here for transparency. In order to display the scope of the analysis, meaning the covered processes and the activities of the organization that are analyzed, the direct and the indirect activities. For this, in order to speak the languages of process owners in an organization, we propose to adapt a business process modeling language, BPMN, which already by default provides some useful features like the possibility to zoom in and zoom out in the processes. Here, when we have a sub-process, for example, transport of glass bottles, and we can see how a zooming in would look like. Like we could extend this process to view the underlying sub-steps, like transport glass bottles would consist of the steps: transport glass bottles by ship first, and then by truck. There are some extensions that we propose to display the sustainability indicators also on the different steps by color coding, and also by providing the normalized indicator value from 0 to 100 here on top of the different steps. All of this comes together by combining them into the dashboard and implementing the tactical design elements, the interactivity, the structured display, and provision of detailed information in context. And one of the most important features here is the realization of drill downs, so the possibility to vary the level of detail in the display. This makes it possible to show the information relationships, to structure the data, and to reduce the complexity of the presentation in order to support the comprehensibility. Both the indicators, so the indicator hierarchy and the processes, may be varied in detail, allowing for a multidimensional analysis of the corporate sustainability. As a further feature, brushing is implemented, so the display adapts when you select only one of the displayed elements to show you the corresponding values. The first prototype of the dashboard was developed to illustrate the visualization and functional design of the dashboard. This first prototype was also used for an evaluation. It is intended as a formative evaluation, so it was not our goal to prove that this is altogether a superior design, but we wanted to find out what is good, what works, what doesn't work, where can we improve the design. And in usability literature, it is said that if you have 5 participants, that is sufficient to uncover most of the usability problems. So we conducted a test with 5 potential users to uncover potential usability problems. The test was performed by observing the behavior and creating a thinking aloud protocol of the users, of the participants, while they performed practical tasks with the dashboard. Additionally, we collected open feedback. What worked? Well, the clarification of a comprehensive sustainability perspective, the holistic sustainability perspective, by presenting the indicator hierarchy was well received. The coloring was intuitively understood. The weighting of the indicators and composition of the aggregation indicators was interpreted correctly. And also the possibility to vary the detail level on both dimensions was seen as very useful. What did not work? Still, the visualizations tended to be perceived as overloaded. The connection between the two graphs, like the indicator hierarchy and the process visualization, was not always clear. The drill down functionality as it was implemented appeared to be complicated. And some users had also initial problems to interpret the bullet graphs. They needed some explanations for that. So what do we see as main contribution of the presented design? Mainly this combined drill-down functionality of processes and indicators supports the communication of lifecycle information, the adaptation of the business process, model annotation, modeling language was used to effectively visualize the sustainability aspects. Limitations, one aspect already discussed, the controversial issue of aggregation. One needs to keep that in mind. Also, links and dependencies between different sustainability dimensions are not regarded in the aggregation scheme. And of course, well, an arbitrary number of indicators can be implemented in the dashboard that does not take away the necessary effort and work needed to actually collect the data to perform the assessments. The implementation of the software prototype so far is more to be seen as a proof of concept, not a fully functional software, so we intend to iterate on this based on the evaluation feedback that we have collected. That's it. Thank you for listening. I have provided several links for you. One, the link to the paper for more details about the implementation and about the aggregation scheme. If you want to get in contact and talk about the integration of business process management and sustainability analysis, here you can find the link to my personal homepage and where you can find the contact information. And the slides are also available online. And I'm very much looking forward to the discussion. Thank you for listening.